مرحبا, how are you? Today I'm going to teach you the top 20 slang Arabic words to help you fit in. Yalla, let's begin. Before we start with the lesson, I want to invite you to like my Facebook page at Learn Arabic with Maha, one word only, and follow me on Instagram at Maha Yaqub for daily Arabic content coming your way on a daily basis. And also, I want to make sure that you know about my Arabic courses online. I've been holding them since February. I have beginner courses, I have advanced courses, I have MSA and Palestinian dialect courses. Anything you need to know about my online Arabic courses or how to join or how to be part of this beautiful, wonderful Arabic learner community, there's a link that leads you to the website with all the information. If you can't join the live classes, there are pre-recorded lessons for you, like real whole online course, but you can watch it offline on the time that you prefer. Without further ado, let's get on with the lesson. Number one is yalla. No need to explain. Yalla is spoken by each and every Arab, whatever his country of origin is. Yalla is a way to encourage people. Yalla, yalla, to say let's go. Yalla nruh, to hang up. Yalla bye. Yalla is يعني, really the word of excellence, like the best or the most used Arabic word by Arabs ever. And it's our number one. Number two, I use it a lot with my students. It's ya shabab. Ya shabab, it's like hey guys. Yeah, another one, an equivalent to it, and I will add it into number two, it's ya jama'a. It comes from the verb jama'a, to collect, to group. Ya jama'a, hey group, but it means hey pals, hey bunch of people. Yeah, ya jama'a and ya shabab. That's also very much used to say hey dude, or hey friends, or hey you, yeah, everybody. It's for a group of people, yeah, it's not you one, it's for a group of people. Ya shabab, yalla ya shabab. You can combine number one with number two. And ya jama'a, ya jama'a. Number three is the word khalas. Khalas, khalas. Khalas is when you're angry and you want to say enough, khalas. Khalas is when you're not angry, you just want to say khalas, don't pour me more coffee. Khalas, khalas, bikafi, thank you. Stop talking, khalas tihki. Yeah, stop talking, like an order, I'm asking you, khalas tihki. You're helping somebody maneuver the car. Khalas, khalas, khalas. Like, stop. That's it. Enough. Enough. Otherwise, you'll hit the other car. So, khalas, khalas. Another thing is when you're angry. Khalas. Khalas. I don't want to hear anything. Khalas. When you're happy, yeah, you've had enough food or like, don't pour me more coffee. Khalas, khalas, bikafi. So, khalas, shukran. You can even like combine khalas with shukran when you're happy. So, khalas, it's like generally to say to somebody stop, to order them. So, it's an imperative verb. But it also means enough when you're also happy, you're not angry. And it doesn't necessarily, it's not used necessarily in negative connotation. Khalas, it means enough. It depends on your intonation. Khalas. Or the lesson ended. Khalas, khilas el dars. Yeah, so it depends on how you say it. The word is khalas. Number four, inshallah. Inshallah. I'm talking to my mom. When are you coming home? Yamma, inshallah on Christmas. Yeah, inshallah. Ya Rab. Inshallah, you'll succeed in the exam. Inshallah, we'll have a lot of children. Inshallah. Inshallah, if God wills. If God wants. Yeah, God willing. Yeah, that's our inshallah. But inshallah, I've made one full lesson about it because it can mean also sometimes no. It depends on the intonation. If you want to know all the variations or to go in depth learning inshallah and all the different ways when we use it to mean different things, I advise you to click on this video or I'll put it in the description below. And you will get more in depth. But inshallah in general is when you're really wishing that God allows you to do something beautiful and positive. Number five, it's wallah. Wallah. Wallah is used so much everywhere, actually. It means like I swear by God, but it's not used literally to say I swear. Yeah? Sometimes. Wallah can also mean really. Yeah? Wallah? Wallah. And it can be the answer. Wallah? Really? Wallah, really? Wallah, like I swear, yes. Wallah, it can mean yes, it can mean really. It can mean that you are swearing. You haven't seen that movie? Yes, I swear, I've seen it. Ah, wallah, أنا شفته للفيلم. Wallah, wallah شفته. Yes, I swear, I've seen it. Come visit us. والله رح اجي الجمعة الجاي. والله رح اجي الجمعة الجاي. I swear I'm gonna come next week. والله والله خلص enough. صدقني believe me. والله رح اجي الجمعة الجاي. So when you're swearing, when you're saying I swear by God, when you wanna say yes, when you wanna say really, والله, yeah, والله. That's the usage of والله. Sometimes it's a way. Last time I was teaching a bunch of students, about 25 students, and I had one American student, which use a lot. One thing that I use while I speak, you know, when you want to calculate what you're saying, but you're still thinking and you need a moment or so, you know, between one sentence and another. My American student would say, so she would like, every 2 or 3 seconds she would say in Arabic this is والله. والله رحت وشفت السيارة والله كانت حمراء والله يعني. It's like very similar to well. Guys, والله it means I swear by God. It means and God literally, but you understood how we use it. Between sentences, you're thinking, you want to say really, a lot of ways. I complicated your life, but wallah, I swear I had good intentions. Wallah.